Hi, I'm Judy Umaki with the League of Women Voters. The League is a nonpartisan organization that has provided voters with unbiased election information since 1920. We've invited candidates to talk with us so you can learn more about them. And joining us now is David Poulson, candidate for Oregon Senate District 19. Good morning, David.
Good morning. Thanks for
being here. Tell us a little bit about yourself and the district in which you're running.
Well, my District 19 is Lake Oswego, West Lynn, south Multnomah County, and also Tualatin and part of Durham. I'm a civil engineer by profession. I am the manager of a business in Lake Oswego called Pace Engineers. Mm-hmm. We have about 36 employees, and our focus is on infrastructure development, transportation, water systems, mm-hmm. sewer systems. We also work, do structural engineering. We're working right now pretty extensively down in on the Tesla Gigafactory down in Reno.
Oh.
We're doing a lot down there. And we also do a lot of work in Intel. Mm. But primarily my career has been focused on building, designing, and having constructed public infrastructure. And I also have a master's of business degree in international business with an emphasis over in China. Mm. And I spent years there, actually bringing senior service facilities to China.
Huh.
And also doing some environmental infrastructure projects there. Mm. So that was quite the experience. And I'm still struggling. I'm fluent in Chinese. I can speak with about a five-year-old. So I'm still struggling on trying to learn the language, but it's been quite an experience doing some engineering work over there.
Yeah. And what's your interest in translating this business into running in the Senate?
Well, a civil engineer is an engineer that works on civilization, and so consequently, everything I've done throughout my whole career has been some aspect of public involvement, mm. not only in infrastructure development, but land use law. Mm. I'm also the chair of the Lake Oswego Development Review Commission. Mm. And so I'm just bringing my problem-solving abilities, I think, to the state Senate, because I think a lot of the issues that we have today would be better off if we thought a little bit harder about them at their inception. For example, if you take a school bond measure and by the time it gets to the voters, it's let's do it for the kids. Mm-hmm. But no one really at the very beginning saying, do we really need to repair this this element of a building because it doesn't meet a seismic code? Maybe we can more afford something that doesn't fall down but doesn't kill anybody but isn't perfect after an earthquake. Mm-hmm. But where are those questions asked at the beginning of projects? And I'd like to, bring that to the Senate and Oregon. A lot of times engineers, what they do is what they do for a living is to solve problems by not just having here's the silver bullet and try to defend it. We solve problems by gathering information, processing it. I call it a self-informing process that leads us to a more informed decision. And I think having those skills, there's just not enough engineering mm-hmm. in state government. And I think bringing that there would be a benefit.
Good. Oregon ranks 48th in the nation in high school graduation rates. What specific measures will you push forward to improve this rate? Like mandating a 180-day school year, like many states have, more technical and vocational education?
Well, I have a little bit different approach to this. First of all, I was not a good high school student mm-hmm. myself. Even though I did graduate, I think it was like a 2.0 grade mm-hmm. point average. And after I spent a few years up in Alaska building houses in miserable conditions, I finally decided it was time to go back to college. And that when I actually did go back, I was truly interested mm-hmm. in solving my self-avowed ignorance. Mm-hmm. And I have not stopped studying since. Mm. I did very well in college and got a degree in engineering and got my MBA, like mm-hmm. I said. So it's been, I have learned what happens when you truly motivate somebody internally to be interested. Mm. And I think one of the things we do wrong in our education system is we are not focused on that. We're focusing more on teaching rather than we are on how people learn. Mm. Now, let me tell you one other thing. I have a son that has a high-functioning autism. Mm. And my wife is currently a doctoral candidate at the University of Portland. We've learned a lot about how people learn through the example of my son. Mm-hmm. And we now know that every individual has got a different learning system that we can identify. It's either their auditory or their visual or their, you know, a motor. They have to actually do things to learn. Mm-hmm. And if we could target each individual, and it's not hard to do, find out what they're best at and present information to them in that way, you can stimulate their interest more. That on top of, I think we ought to relook at our curriculum and actually change it so that the information we're providing to students is, you know, relative, meaningful, and practical to their lives. Because if that was the case, they might actually get an interest in something. And you stimulate that internal drive in a human, and I think Katie barred the door, because that's what happened to me. And I'm a lifelong learner now. And so, you know, I think we could probably do other things mechanically to change the school year and, you know, change the, you know, how many days they go to school and things like that. But I think fundamentally, we need to change the way people become interested in things.
Interesting. Good. Election integrity is a very important issue for the League and for many citizens. Tell voters how you stand on some of these things. Setting up a nonpartisan redistricting commission so that redistricting would no longer be a legislative process?
Well, I couldn't be more for that, because in my district, my opposition has been in charge of that districting process for a while now. And if you think about my district, you have Lake Oswego and West Lynn and Tualatin, but then they've brought in this thin sliver up in South Multnomah County. Mm. Now, those other three areas or cities are, you know, it's a little bit still weighted towards the Democratic side, but it's something that I feel good in engaging in. But it's that Multnomah County piece, which is 80% Democrat. Mm. For me to be able to overcome that is really changes my whole election campaign strategy. Mm. So, of course, I'm for a nonpartisan redistricting approach.
What about setting up a small donor election system and implementing more complete disclosure of campaign contributions?
Well, I think that's great too. I'm all for the total transparency. I have to say that what I've done in terms of gaining donations and things like that, the way I submit that to my campaign accountant has been very, very transparent. So I don't have that many complaints about it. I'm sure on a different scale, there's other issues that I'm probably not smart enough to understand how people are creative to find ways to circumvent that. But I'm all for anything we can do to make it a more transparent process, because I don't think money should influence how much time somebody gets in front of the public.
What do you think about passing the national popular vote bill so that every vote counts the same across the country when electing the president?
Oh, no, I would be absolutely against that, because, you know, it was founded as a republic, and I want to keep it a republic. And if we had time to go into why I have such strong views on that, I would love to get into that. But that kind of brings in my whole feeling about, you know, the nature of the Constitution and why a republic would be a better form of government than just a pure democracy. So I'm really not for that popular vote. If that was the case, then California and New York would probably select the president every time. Mm.
And why should the people vote for you rather than your opposition?
Well, I have more in the trenches experience. Mm-hmm. I've been engaged in these type of, I think public infrastructure is going to be a huge issue going forward, where, you know, our infrastructure is 100 years old and crumbling, needs to be replaced. Are we going to replace it the same way we designed it 100 years ago? Or are we going to bring some of the green, sustainable solutions that I can bring to the table? Because that's what I've done, is actually design and build these things. And so I see how going from, let's say, a centralized treatment plant to a decentralized treatment plant would work beautifully when the time comes when autonomous cars are here, or the virtual world seems to replace the physical world or kind of merge with those two. Those changes are coming, and somebody like myself who's been engaged with that, these changes would be, I think, more appropriate. You know, that's also my education background through my son, I think, is also qualifies me. And finally, I have, through my MBA, I really have quite an economics background. Mm. And I understand, I think, what we need to do to stimulate the economy here in Oregon. So for the past 20, 30 years, the economy has evolved into more of an asset-owning economy. Mm. We're owning houses and you know, watching the price of that asset goes up seems to be the economic investment choice of people, not producing something. So I'd love to see us diversify our economy back to production. And one of the things I would like to do would be re-engage with our force in order to diversify our economy, stimulate more jobs, help rural Oregon at the same, and then that would help us be ready for when the next downturn comes. Because nothing's more unstable ultimately than an economy that's based on just owning assets. Yeah. And leverage credit. And so that's what I think ultimately qualifies me, is that I have that background, an engineering background, and I've always been engaged with the public.
Yeah, so. Good. Thank you so much for coming in, David.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it.
Oh, my pleasure.
Best of luck.
All right, thank you.